Hey everyone, this is Judy with JLB Crafts. Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, thank you so much for giving me a try. In this video, I'm going to be setting up two monthly views. This is the monthly view for my social media planner, and then in the second half of the video, we're going to go ahead and do my wellness and fitness planner. So stay tuned for that if you want to see a couple different ones. So for this one, I track what video posts each day, and I always used highlighters. So like Wednesdays are my wellness videos, and so I highlight them in blue. But now I have enough colors of my different Girl Boss Hanna overlay tapes that I can go ahead and do that. So the advantage is, A, they're removable, but B, they don't make your pen smear like sometimes highlighters do. So you gotta be careful. You write something and then you highlight over it and it smears. And what are you gonna do when that happens? So overlay tapes, that doesn't happen. Plus, like I said, they very specifically are made to be removable. So the theme I'm gonna go with, anytime I have an opportunity to do a spread and I don't have a challenge that I'm planning on following, I like to grab a sticker book, because I haven't ordered a Happy Planner sticker book in quite some time, actually, now that I think about it. But I do regularly have new sticker books coming in, mostly from smaller shops, and so I like to grab whatever I have gotten relatively recently that I haven't used yet. And so I got the Planny Thing Houses and Trees Part 2. I was so excited about it, and then I haven't used it yet. So I decided I was going to use this. If you live on Earth, and obviously all of us do, it is hot, especially in the Northern Hemisphere. We are all over having heat waves, and so rather than like dream of not a heat wave, I thought, hey, you know, what says hot? And so these stickers caught my attention big time. They are like desert oasis kind of stickers. And they combine two of my favorite colors. This kind of, I love pink and green, but like earthy pink and green, not like bright, cartoony pink and green. And so this is more of almost a brown peachy pink, and this is more of not like emerald green, but like an earthy, soft, like herby almost green. And then the monkeys, they're super cute. So we are going to use these. This new book has a slightly different format. All the box stickers for this book are way in the back. And there are lots and lots of plain ones, and then there are also some that have the deco in the corners of the boxes. But there aren't really, I want to stick to these soft colors because my overlay tapes are going to bring a lot of color to the page. And so there aren't enough of these. There, first of all, let me say, if you don't have this book, there are two different kinds of palm trees. There are these more brown palm trees, and then there are also in here these more brightly beachy green palm trees. So these definitely are beach. You can see the water in there, and these, like the house, some of the houses are up on stilts. These are beach. These are desert. These are like desert oasis ones. So we're sticking with the desert oasis ones for this spread. So I don't want this one because that's the beachy one. You can see the water, and those are green and these are brown. So I pulled a couple, all of that to say, I pulled a couple other sticker books. I've got the Kel of a Plan Neutral Basics and the Mojo Jojo Pastel boxes, because I felt like these had soft enough colors to give me the boxes I need to go with this sticker. So let's, enough hand waving and stuff, let's get started. I also have pulled a Simply Gilded washi tape to go with it. So this is a recent one. This is the chocolate from the Chocolate Milk collection, and I just feel like this brown, it matches so well. So I have the set, so I have the wide and the skinny. I'm definitely putting the skinny across the bottom. The other thing I like to take note of when I'm deciding what I want to do decoration wise is, where are the empty boxes? So there are always empty boxes, because there are 35 boxes in this layout, but there are at most only 31 days in a month. So you're going to have at least 4 empty boxes. So here's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I can build a little scene down here, or I could put all my functional, a lot of my functional stuff down there. We'll decide. But so for now, I'm just going to run the skinny one across the bottom. And then I need to decide, am I also going to use the skinny one across the top? Because it will fit above the date. Or do I want to use the wide one across the top and just partly cover up August. I haven't decided yet, so start sending me your thoughts on that so I hear them by the time I get to there. I do have a link in the description box for Simply Gilded. If you sign up for the No Spam newsletter, you will get a coupon for $5 off a purchase of $15 or more, and I will get that same coupon. Okay. Don't pull your washi tape super tight. It doesn't make so much of a difference on this particular side of my layout because this is the monthly divider. It's a little thicker, but on a normal sized page, it will cause your page to curl because it expands if you pull it super tight. I mean, you can't really see it, but trust me, it does. And then when you unstick it from your desk, it contracts, and that's what causes the page to curl. So, all right, so do I want to go skinny and stay completely above 2022? Or do I want to go fat and partially cover it up? Because the problem is the bottom of the G and the Y's will stick down below it. If it was like June and all of it was up under there, that would be okay, but still the 2022 wouldn't be, so we'll stick with skinny. And Planty Things stickers don't have any foil, so the foil on this washi tape will set any foil then elements that I want to add to this spread. I will try to stick to this light gold. So I like to start with big stickers first because they need the biggest chunk of space. And so I think this is a nice big sticker. So all I need to do is I wrote monthly. I showed you one right here. I have monthly that I wrote with a flare, and then I stuck the Girl Boss Anna overlay tape over the top. So for those of you that didn't know, everything I do on social media is color coded. Everything monthly is gray. So the thumbnail on my, YouTube channel, if you see a gray one, it's something that only happens once a month. It's a monthly thing. Wellness, if it's blue, it's wellness, and so on and so forth. So I can't get away from having lots of colors on here, but it looks good when it's all done. So here's a nice big sticker. It is, though, it's so big, it's definitely gonna come over to the 28. I could come here, and it's okay if whatever I put here comes up into these three boxes a little bit, as long as I have room to write a line of text. So if I sat this right down on the washi tape, it's gonna come up, ooh, a lot. Okay, so this is too big. This is not really gonna, I could put it here. If I put it way up here, so I have this box and all the way up to here. Let's see if I could put it. Yeah, I could put it there. It doesn't matter if it covers up Sunday a little bit. Let's do it. That's going to really set a nice tone for the spread, in my opinion, using this nice big sticker up there in the corner. So that's where noticing where my empty boxes were right off the bat came in handy. All right, let's see if I can get this stuck down where I want it the first time. So I don't want much of this tree to be off the page, so it's gonna cause me to come over a bit. Cute. Ooh, I like that. That's perfect up there. Okay. And I kind of feel like I want one of these little monkeys somewhere. We'll see. We'll see where I can fit that in. So I need to save myself space for, let's see, 1, 2, 3 sets of boxes, a slightly large one, and then a couple smaller ones. So what I track in those is income from a couple different sources. So I could use maybe these two boxes for that. And then I do my month change on followers on Instagram and YouTube. I'm trying to talk and flip at the same time and it's not working. let's see here. So just thinking if I could do a big box and fit all that stuff in there. It's messing me up that all the boxes are in the back. I got used to her books being set up the other way. So is that the same color? Yes. Okay, so there's one. So what I do is, like, for YouTube, I'll do start end and change. So I could fit 6 lines of text in there and get all of that in one box. So what I'm a little all over the place. I'm trying to decide, do I want to put all my functional stuff here and put all decoration down there? Which is, I think, what I want to go for, because if I have decoration here and decoration here and functional stuff down here, then it's lopsided, right? But if I do deco here and deco here, and then all my videos and functional stuff here, it feels like the two clusters of deco being opposites balance things a little better. So let's just make the decision and do it and put the deco down here. Now, what I could do is deco, and those two functional boxes in between, since they both have, they have a little decoration on them. So that my two little income boxes that I said I wanted to have. So if I put them together, but the one with the palm tree, I put the tree in the middle, then the deco kind of can be enough to cover both. So if we go all the way up with this one, kind of toward the center. So I've got 1, 2, 3. So my center is right here, the center of the center box. So if I put it right up at the top, and then I overlap this one just a little bit so that that tree's a little more in the center. There we go. And now if I have room for a little bit more deco on either side. So I could put a nice, I could put it like a taller palm tree here along the edge. Now I think I want, is there a skinny enough house to put on there? Maybe that one. The other thing I can do is shift them a little bit so I can fit this on. If I put this one down, it sticks up a little bit, but not too much. Let's put that one. I think this one. All right, so here's what we're going to do. I did not stick those down. I don't know if you can tell or not. They're not stuck down. So if I sit this right on the washi tape, oh, that's so cute. All right, but I do need to move them over a little bit. So let's try to lift them up. And what you can do is park these on the back of your hand. They'll pick up, hopefully this isn't too gross, they'll pick up just a few of your skin cells and the oils on your skin. And it's like sticking it on wax paper. So I just, for these two little stickers, I don't feel like getting my wax paper out, but I wouldn't mind if they were just a little less sticky. So I put them on the back of my hand like that, and then that helps with the stickiness. All right, so I want to just barely tuck this under the fronds of that palm tree. So, and then this one I wanted under and up. Perfect. And now let's find a little palm tree or something to bookend that. So like one of these, maybe this one. Those with the monkeys. I could put a monkey on there too. How about this one? And maybe we'll stick a monkey on there too. I feel like that washi tape is my sand. Oh, look at him hanging. Can we get him on there somehow? Yeah, I think this little guy's sitting. Let's do him. I'm not necessarily, you know, a huge monkey person. I just do like animals though. I feel like they're innocent souls and we should do everything we can to help them. Okay, all right, cool. So there's some function. Next I need function over here. And a quote maybe. So I can do functional and quote, and that would kind of balance. If I did a big dark quote down here, that could kind of balance with those. So let's put the functional box there in the middle. So I'm gonna see, let's see, I think there was one. Yeah, here we go. And I already checked, this is the right color. All right, park it on the back of my hand. Come back to our deco. All right, so if this is my, basically my monthly stat information, I can put it right up against the bottom of the sticker, and it looks like it just helps create more of the floor that the sticker is sitting on. All right. And then for quotes, then I just got, so again, another new one. There are no quotes in this book. I just got the Kelleva Plan Rainbow Quotes book. So maybe we can find something brown or black that'll fit in there. Okay, lots of black quotes. Something plannery. I don't think I want gray because these are all greens and peachy soft browns. So I'm just going to, I'm not going to read them all, but I do, okay, I'm looking for something kind of long and that will fit in that space. So if only common sense was more common. Not feeling sassy. I'm struggling with the colors. I guess this one's brown enough. Strive for progress, not perfection. I like that one. That's what we're going to go with. I just feel like the very first quote I should I should use out of a rainbow quote book should be colored. So now, though, I want to kind of try to decorate it a little bit. So do I put another building down there? Is it bold enough to show up over those trees? It definitely is. So if I put one more little building down here, even though I said I wanted to keep it balanced, I feel like, well, I guess not. I don't need to make it super, super full, right? We'll just center it in the space. Strive for progress, not perfection. That's cute. Maybe I'll put this little monkey down here. Just a little bit of decoration and maybe a little tree. So I put him down here. Do you want lunch? Hello. Keep going, please. Keep going, please. Hi, baby. And one more tree. Maybe I can find a skinny one to put up. I could put that super, super big one, but maybe this one. Because I feel like the monkey needs a tree. What do you think, Jasper? Does the monkey need a tree? So if I put it right at the very, very edge of the page, then I can trim off the rest of that. There it is. I want it to be under the quote, though. I can trim off the edge and attach it somewhere else. There, that's cute. We just gotta figure out where we can stick this little bit of palm tree. Where can we put it, dude? I think I want the monkey over here closer to the palm tree. I know. That was tiny, but... Excuse me. It's not lunchtime yet. Oh, can I have this? Thank you. Let's just put it right here. To add a little more palm tree to that scene. There we go. Okay. Excuse me. Come over here. Come on. All right. That's pretty much it. Although I feel like this needs to move down a little bit. It's not. I put it there so that it looked like the scene was sitting on top of it, but I don't like it. And since I stuck it to the back of my hand, see how easy it's peeling up now? Let's move it down a bit. Let's just center it in that space. That's better. All right, there we go. So stay tuned and we'll do my wellness and fitness planner. All right, so for my wellness and fitness planner, the monthly view, all I write in here is symptoms. So ladies, you can track monthly things in there. If you know you go to the doctor because something has started bothering you, if you keep track of when it started bothering you and how maybe how quickly the pain increased or whatever, here, then you have something to refer back to. So it's also though mental wellness, so you know, you can leave some journaling space on here and whatnot. So I did already white out the word notes that was on the page. I am using the seasonal floral sticker book, and my first inclination is always to grab, sorry, planner, is to grab the sticker book that coordinates with it. But then I'm like, well, I want flowers that match those, but I already have those on the page. So I again went to a new sticker book that I got that I haven't used yet. So Layering Basics Volume 2 by Amber Plans Her Day. And just flipping through here, looking for something that I felt like this page of colors really went surprisingly well with that. Obviously, the artwork style is completely different, but I like that the colors match. I mean, almost every color on this sticker is in this here. And then when I saw this page as my jumping off point, I went, there is a wellness book. So you may not have this, it's older, but the colors in this book blend well with the colors in this. So we're just gonna do a few little clusters, different things around. I wanna cover that up to make this. I love my serene nature, earth vibes in this planner. So we're gonna go for that. So just looking for journaling boxes, or I want something big to put down here in this three box space. So at most I would write, you know, a quick a symptom or two on here. So these are possibilities. I could layer these with these, but I want something bigger, I think, for down here. Here we go. Create your own sunshine. Let's put that down here. It's nice and big, and let's layer it with one of these, maybe coming up from the corner. So I don't want to put yellow with yellow, though. How about this, like this one or this one? There's purple on this one. There's not on that one. So let's grab this one because it's got a little bit of purple. I'm just going to put it, try to tuck it into the corner as best I can. And I'll have to trim the excess white sticker off the edges, but that's totally okay. I'm not going to put any washi tape on this one. And then let's layer this one over top of it. Oh yeah, that's cute. So as long as the other video was, this one's going to be quick. So, all right. So that was the only empty space on this page. Now I want to definitely cover this up. We could almost do something similar with Radiate Good Vibes coming this way and a paper floral here. Why not? Let's do it. So I don't want to use that same one. The amazing thing Amber has done with this sticker book is you get two copies of a lot of the florals and stuff in here, but she mirrored them. So I could absolutely use this one going this way paired with this quote. How cool is that? So like these two are the same but mirrored. I love that. I love that somebody who's creating stickers thought that far ahead for us. But you know, I kind of am liking this one because it's got some of these same little like shapes. Let's do it because I want something big enough to cover that white out, but also be kind of tucked into the corner. And then Radiate Good Vibes. Yes, love it. Still have plenty of room to write something on these days if I need to. Okay, empty sticker page. So make sure, I'm gonna go ahead and pull it out, pull the outline from the stickers off of there. And now you've got, let's say you're traveling and you're gonna have to do a spread. You can pull all the stickers you need for your spread and put them on this page and take it with you and plan on the road. So just one way to use this, but definitely save this. Okay. Let's see if there's maybe... So I've got something in each of the four corners. That's good. What can we put here? Maybe a big like paper quote sticker or something. So I think I'll save those two and not, I mean, that one is obviously way too big to fit on here. That might need to go on like a goals page. Anything here? I don't really want planning stickers. I don't have to-dos or anything. Your greatest wealth is your health. I don't have kind of a hit of purple on here anywhere, so I could put this on here maybe with maybe a peachy sticker. Do I want more of these? I kind of do. This one's going to be quick, like I said. Let's do it. So if I come down here... So words makes me want to bring this one down. And then I think I want to pair it with like peach, something peachy. I'm just struggling because I want space here too, but I don't know if I want the peach, the floral to be super close to that one. You know what I mean? There's not a really jumping out at me a good way to arrange this. I'm not liking it. Maybe some kind of journaling, wellness type journaling prompt right there. Here we go, like inspirational quote. That's a good one. There's that same shade of purple. Or a gratitude sticker. That's completely different. Let's use one of these. So let's come down here, because I don't want to put this floral right next to this floral. Let's bring it down here. Maybe if I put this one on this side, so let's grab the one that's facing the other direction. So if I bring it over here instead of over here, they're not quite as lined up. Although it's a little bit big for that. No, let's do this one. I'm changing my mind. Let's do this one. Layered kind of here. So I just want to make sure that my 14, well, I don't need my 14 to show, but since this sticker has lots of cutouts and zigs and zags, it's pretty easy to place it so that the 14 does show. There we go. And then if I put just one more little box or something right there, I think it'll look broken up enough, you know? So another little, oops, wrong book. This book. Today was practice gratitude. Let's just find some. Oh, here we go. What about one of these? Give yourself a pep talk. I've used these here before. Hi, buddy. How about give yourself a pep talk? Does that fit right there? It kind of does. What are these? Taking time for myself. Focus word. Look how well these colors match. That's so awesome. I could write a focus word in there. Let's do it. I'm gonna pick this same color because I've got the floral in between. So for balance, I feel like picking this same color makes sense. Are you sitting on my tweezers? Can I have these? There, that's better than what I was gonna do. I feel like that is random, has random balance, you know what I mean? So, all right, so I think that's it. The other thing I like to do, can I have my page, please? Thank you. Sometimes is sprinkle little words and things around. And this book has a lot of good ones in it. So let me show you what I mean. But it's a good way to use those little words. Here we go. Take a break. Since I've got all the different colors, I can sprinkle these around. So let's just do that real quick. Let's sprinkle these around. So make some tea, digital detox, that's a good one. Let's just sprinkle some of these around. Let's put them on there straight though, huh? Practice gratitude. I already have practice gratitude there. I can't do yoga anymore. I messed up my knee and my back. That's a good one for the weekend. Early bedtime. I love going to bed early and just laying there and reading. Let's do one more right there. I think there's another page. Yep. Meditate. Another good one. All right, let's do the other side. Exercise. Eat healthy. That's a good one. Or, ooh, be creative. I don't really pay attention to holidays in this particular planner, so I could cover that up with another one. Face mask. Exercise. Did I put meditate? I did. Face mask. Eat healthy. I don't think I put eat healthy on there yet. And one more. Did I put no screen time? I did not. Let's do no screen time. Although I love to read, but my books are on my phone. So does that count as no screen time? I don't know. There we go. All right. So just little reminders. If you check them off, you do. If you don't, you don't. that's it. That is my Wellness and Fitness Monthly. Pretty simple for that one. And I could put bigger things on there, but that was what was in the book. So I hope you like this video. I hope it encourages you to at least try doing a little bit of decoration on your monthly. If you decorate it, you're more likely to look at it, which makes you more likely to use it, and it won't go to waste. So I hope you like this video. If you do, please consider liking and subscribing. Thank you.